The Haymaker Farmers Market is happening now on campus. We have live updates ahead.
Need some help with creating a resume and a cover letter? Find out where you can attend those sessions and more.
President Biden used his first United Nations address this morning to discuss a new era of diplomacy. His plan ahead.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Will you be loving what McDonald's is coming out with, what people are calling hamburger chic? Find out as TV2 News starts now.
This is TV2 News.
Good Tuesday evening, Portage County, and thank you for joining us. The Haymaker Farmers Market is happening on campus as we speak, and that is where we will begin. I'm Alexandria Manthey.
And I'm Kelsey Drennen. That's right, this is the first time the Haymaker Farmers Market made its way to Kent's campus.
The university is saying this is a great way to introduce students to locally grown and nutritious foods. Our reporter Austin Rupert is on the scene to give you more. Hi, Austin.
Thanks, guys. And even though the fall weather may be on hold, the Kent State Farmers Market is in full swing here at the Risman Plaza Student Green. In a recent partnership with Kent's own Haymakers Farmers Market, the university-sponsored market seeks to provide students with an opportunity to learn about local farming community, select fresh produce, and connect to the broader Kent community. With over 20 vendors out today, including the Wolf Family Farm and Pete's Organic Tea, students and visitors alike are having a great time looking through a wide selection of foods, plants, art, and much more. With live music from bluegrass band Ohio Crossroads and blues band Hot Potato. Also, the best part is that flash cash is accepted. Weren't able to make it out today? That's not a problem. The Kent State Farmers Market will return right here to Risman Plaza on Tuesday, October 12th at 4 p.m. The market will also return for the new year on Tuesday, March 22nd and Tuesday, April 26th. At the Design Innovation Hub. Reporting live from the Kent State campus, for TV2, I'm Austin Rupert.
Thanks, Austin. And Kent State is defining their plan to implement Collins Law. Collins Law is an anti-hazing act named after Colin Wyant, who passed away close to 3 years ago in a hazing incident. The law increases penalties for hazing up to a third-degree felony and bystanding up to a first-degree misdemeanor. Dennis Campbell, Assistant Director for Fraternity and Sorority Life, says the campus already implements aspects that are in Collins Law. KSU Greek organizations are refining their hazing policy to hold individuals accountable.
And the faculty union and Kent State have come to an agreement regarding the vaccination requirements for faculty at the university. This agreement states that all full-time non-tenure track and tenure track faculty must either receive a COVID-19 vaccine or request an exemption. One of these need to be submitted by November 1st, and if faculty members do not comply by December 20th, they may be subject to formal sanctions.
Kent State was once again named one of the nation's most LGBTQ-friendly colleges by an organization called Campus Pride. This is the second time in 2 years the university has landed its name on the list. KSU also earned a perfect 5 out of 5 stars on the Campus Pride Index for second straight year, accounting for one of only 30 schools in the country to receive this honor. Career fair for Kent State is right around the corner.
That's right, Alex. TV2's very own Allie Kiphart is here to tell you everything you need to know. Allie?
Kent State University is holding its annual career fair, available for student and alumni tomorrow. The 2021 Fall Career Fair Exploration Fair is taking place September 22nd from 2 to 6 p.m., 100% virtually and through Handshake. Over 200 organizations and employers are attending. The fair is open for all students and alumni searching for jobs, internships, on-campus opportunities, and so much more. The fair includes group and one-on-one video sessions for students to hear about every opportunity available for them. The fair also has people available for students to track their paths after graduation. Students can learn about careers that are associated with their major and express interests and curiosities to a professional. The fair is a great way for students to gain connections, and for more information, visit kent.edu/career. This is Allie Kiphart. Have a good evening.
Good Tuesday evening, Portage County. I'm Nathan Welsh with my Dilbert tie with your Wednesday weather forecast. Now, currently in Kent, it is 69, feels like 69. It's rainy. I don't know what you'd feel other than really rain. Humidity 84% because our dew point is at 64%. Visibility out to 9 miles. Now, across Northeast Ohio, we have temperatures around the high 60s, early 70s. It's that fall weather coming to us, at least via temperature. Now, as we look across the rest of Ohio, again, similar trends. It's all mid to low 70s. Now, tomorrow is the first day of fall. I know I'm excited. We got sweaters and flannels and jeans, boots, all that. We got the colors changing. We'll see those leaves falling off the trees. Everything will be orange and brown, two of my favorite colors. Got seasonal drinks, the PSLs at, I know, Starbucks especially, but I kind of like the Dunkin' ones. And fall festivals, I know I'm excited. I'm so excited. But, of course, this does mean that today is the last day of summer. And quite one at that. Very, very not summery day. A lot of rain, as I'm sure you saw if you've looked out your window or been outside at all. But stay tuned. I'll have your 7-day forecast and more after the break.
If you receive the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccination, you may soon be able to receive a booster shot.
And these new outfits might make you crave a hamburger. You heard me right. Find out what McDonald's is doing to the fashion world.
Love is love.
I feel like her heartbeat is like same speed as mine. And I think we have this like deep connection, this heart connection in her heart that there's room for me and mom. When I'm holding her, it makes me feel calmer. It's a sensory thing. It's a thing with Asperger's.
She's really good with Anya. I've seen adults react to my daughter when she has meltdowns, like she's from a different planet. And this little animal just sat next to my child and was just like, you know, it's gonna be cool.
She's my superhero.
Good job, kitty cat.
When we adopted Lucky, we discovered all the wonderful things that make her unique.
Lucky's a little bit of a lot of things, but mostly she's pure love.
Okay. Ohio's COVID-19 cases continued to rise, and today's number of hospitalizations proved to be the highest single day since mid-January. Today, there were 459 newly reported hospitalizations. During the recent completed reporting week, 230 Americans that were aged 39 and younger were admitted to the hospital, which is the highest number of admissions for this age group during the entire pandemic. Governor DeWine released an update today on the increased impact that COVID-19 is having on the younger Ohio population. He said, quote, "Those who are getting very sick, being hospitalized, and dying of COVID are getting younger and younger, and it is because they are not vaccinated." Around 97% of patients of all ages in Ohio hospitals today are unvaccinated.
And if you got the COVID vaccine from Johnson & Johnson, you can receive their booster shot, which will protect you against COVID-19 for longer. According to the latest trials, people who received a booster shot 2 months after getting the shot boosted the protection against COVID from 66% to 94%. Experts said that booster shots for the coronavirus will be needed down the road, and that J&J's trial supports this claim.
Catholic Diocese of Cleveland Bishop Emeritus Anthony M. Pilla passed away this morning. Pilla was the diocese's ninth bishop and served from 1981 to 2006 when he retired. He was succeeded by former Bishop Richard Lennon, who passed in 2019. The current Cleveland bishop, Edward C. Malasek, announced his death, describing him as, quote, "a very warm, kind-hearted, and deeply faithful shepherd."
Hello again, I'm Nathan Welsh, back with your weather forecast. Now, tonight, as I'm sure you expected, our showers are going to continue through tonight. I'm going to be here all day tomorrow and tomorrow night. It's a lot of rain. It's fine. But sunset at 7:24, it's getting closer and closer. You know, fall's coming, earlier sunsets. It's all good. It's all good. Now, as we look into tonight, again, just rain the entire time as our temperatures are starting to decrease throughout the night from 69 to 67. And into the next day from 66 to 70, back to 67. Again, rain, not getting any sun anymore, at least just for tomorrow. Because as we look ahead, we're going to see some sun later. But for right now, it's just going to be rain and clouds and colder temperatures. And we got showers stopping for Friday. Awesome. And coming back on Saturday, then stopping on Sunday, and it's just going to be partly cloudy. Some sun, which is nice. Temperatures kind of coming back up, but it's still a nice gentle fall temperature of 74. Again, time to break out those flannels, those sweaters, all that jazz. I've been Nathan Welsh with your weather forecast, telling you to enjoy the upcoming fall weather.
Thanks, Nathan. On Tuesday, President Joe Biden used his first speech to the United Nations General Assembly to explain how civic leadership will be used to help resolve persistent problems such as the coronavirus, climate change, and cyber war.
I prioritize rebuilding our alliances, revitalizing our partnerships, and recognizing they're essential and central to America's enduring security and prosperity.
Biden delivered a message proclaiming a new chapter for America after his decision to end the war in Afghanistan. He explained to world leaders how America is not seeking a divided world or a second Cold War. Biden also expressed his desire to strengthen America's alliances with other countries, not break them.
And the United States has also extended its land border restrictions with Canada and Mexico through October 21st. These COVID-19 rules and land border restrictions prohibit non-U.S. residents in Mexico and Canada from crossing the border for non-essential travel.
There are still votes to be counted, but what we've seen tonight is that millions of Canadians have chosen a progressive plan.
Prime Minister Justin Trudeau won his third election, but failed to get the majority in Parliament that he wanted. Canadians did not want a conservative government during a pandemic, as citizens have voiced their concerns about those who refuse to get vaccinated. Trudeau supports making vaccines mandatory for Canadians to travel by air and rail. U.S. President Joe Biden called Trudeau on Tuesday to congratulate him on his victory. Soon, you can rep your favorite fast food chain. The newest hamburger-inspired fashion coming up.
The women's golf team competed in another invitational, and yet another Kent State athlete has won a Player of the Week award.
Awkward.
I'm the awkward silence.
You try to avoid me, then there I am again.
But an awkward silence can be a great thing.
Like Kelly here is about to demonstrate.
You haven't really been yourself lately. Are you okay?
Find out how you can help a friend with their mental health at seizetheawkward.org.
Awkward.
I'm the awkward silence.
You try to avoid me, then there I am again.
But an awkward silence can be a great thing.
Like Kelly here is about to demonstrate.
You haven't really been yourself lately. Are you okay?
Find out how you can help a friend with their mental health at seizetheawkward.org.
Your TV2 Sports Report.
Welcome to Tuesday Night Sports. My name is Ian Herrmann. We will begin tonight with how the women's golf did in their latest invitational. The Kent State women's golf team was in action the last 2 days in the Mercedes-Benz Women's Intercollegiate Championship in Tennessee. After three rounds of play, the Flashes finished in 11th out of 17th place with a total team score of 878, 26 over par. Now let's look at how the women did individually. The next time the women will be in action will be October 11th and 12th in Illinois for the Illini Women's Invitational. The Kent State women's field hockey team continues to dominate this season, and the MAC is noticing their outstanding play. For the third week this season, a Flash has been awarded Player of the Week. Junior Sydney Washburn was all over the score sheet in Kent State's 3-2 double overtime win against the Ohio Bobcats. Washburn had the first goal and the game winner to cap off the Flash's second straight double OT win. The 23rd ranked Flashes head to Michigan for a game against Central Michigan on Friday and against the number one ranked Michigan Wolverines on Sunday. Both games start at 1 p.m. And now we will head to Green Bay, where the Lions visited the Packers on Monday Night Football. We'll pick it up in the first quarter. Lions looking to score first. Jared Goff gets the snap, and they will do just that. To the left, Quintez Cephas, touchdown. Lions up 7-0 early in this one. But it's the Packers' turn to score. Aaron Rodgers dumps it off to Aaron Jones. He'll run that into the left for the touchdown. He had a big night. Tie game at 7. And now we'll head to the second quarter. Lions looking to retake the lead. And Jared Goff will find TJ Hockenson back in the end zone. Touchdown, Lions. That would be a 14-7 lead. But 2 minutes to go in the half now. Rodgers will take the snap, will roll right and throw to Aaron Jones yet again. Second touchdown of the game, tied at 14 going into the half. third quarter. Lions up 17-14. Rodgers with the ball, and he will heave one of his infamous long balls to Davante Adams down to the Lions' 25-yard line. Huge gain there for the Packers. And to the fourth quarter, Packers looking to put it away. Aaron Jones, one of his four touchdowns on the day. Packers win 35-17. And that is all I have for sports for tonight. My name is Ian Herrmann. I hope you all have a great rest of your night.
The fast food chain McDonald's will have you McLoving their new apparel. Stick with us for the details.
Planning the right amount of food is hard. The Guesstimator makes it easy. Just tell it who's coming and what's for dinner. Then it tells you how much to make. And yes, it even plans for leftovers. Try it at SaveTheFood.com.
Even though there is so much against us, you will see me wearing a face covering.
And even with my face covered,
you will see me
as a son,
as a friend to everyone I meet,
as a fighter for change,
as a woman who stands up for what I believe in.
So join me in wearing a face covering
to help stop the spread of the coronavirus.
Because this is one small act of kindness that has the power to bring us all together.
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
Wizard, roll for deceasedness.
My dark wizard casts Super Fireball.
The wizard has only rolled an 8.
What? This is garbage!
Ten spell. No way level a roll like that 10. Doesn't hit a level 1
I have 7.
You gotta be kidding
me. Oh my god, what is going on? Okay. Goblin.
Cease your quarreling, children.
What?
No! What are you doing, you crazy monster?
Nanny?
Oh my god.
What?
You should stop being nerds and playing D&D and be nerds and watch All Systems Go Wednesdays at 9, where we talk everything from movies, games, to anime and more.
Yeah, no, seems reasonable.
Go watch All Systems Go.
If you have a vehicle, you may want to hear this one. In what's called the world's most connected highway, connecting the cities between Dublin and Marysville, is officially no more. The 35-mile freeway will now serve as a one-of-a-kind vehicle testing ecosystem. This is being designed to improve safety by providing a variety of geographical and meteorology conditions for advanced vehicle testing.
And are you a McDonald's stan? Well, now you can show your love for the fast food chain by wearing their new line of apparel and accessories. Hoodies, backpacks, and purses are just some of the items you can purchase to show that you're loving it while also helping those in need. They partnered with Feeding America and will donate a meal to someone in need for every $10 spent on the merchandise.
All right, Kelsey, I don't know about you, but I love McDonald's, so I might just have to get me some McDonald's merch.
I don't know, honestly. I feel like I'm not the biggest McDonald's fan, if I'm not gonna lie. I'd rather go to, like, Wendy's.
But what about the Sprite?
I know that we had this talk last week, and the Sprite is great, but I don't know. The only reason why I would buy it is for the Feeding America,
yeah,
that part.
Goes to a great cause. I think the backpack is cute.
The backpack? I'm not gonna lie.
The backpack.
I looked at it and I was like, yeah, it does look actually kind of nice. I also did like the crew neck. The crew neck was pretty good, honestly.
Yes. And I couldn't tell if they were pants or pajama pants, but I don't know. Maybe I'll be going to sleep in some McDonald's pajama pants.
The pajama pants? I do need some.
Right. All right. Well, that is all the time we have for today.
For updates on these stories and more, visit KentWired.com and follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at KentWired. My name is Kelsey Drennen.
And I'm Alexandria Manthey. Have a great night, Portage County.
Put the keys down, Kevin.
But I'm gonna drive home.
There are several warning signs present that you shouldn't be driving.
My text to emoji ratio has gotten a little out of hand.
A little?
Yep, I'm definitely gonna call a ride home.
Hey, Bobo, do trees tell each other stories?
I'm sorry, I'm afraid I don't know that.
Hey, why don't we go find out? Listen.
There's a lot of fear in coming back to school. I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but one of the teachers was Miss Araceli. She gave me direction. Every single time I had a question, she'll put down whatever she's doing and she'll sit there with you until you get it. 50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
They call me Prince like I'm royalty or something. But the places I've lived ain't no palaces. So I don't need grilled salmon or a new scratching post. Just give me a cardboard box and a can of tuna and we're good. You can even change my name. I'm cool being the kitty formerly known as Prince.
A big responsibility.
Oh, it's huge. I know, it's huge.
And the salary.
Oh my god, yes. Right? I mean, like, I was about to move in with my parents, and right before, yeah, so this saved me.
I really believe in you, you know?
Thank you. It's nice to hear that from someone.
These are cool. Did you,
I gotta tell Michaela.
What?
Oh my gosh!
Jane! You would not believe. What?
Oh my god. What? Oh, the blurb's on at 9 on Tuesdays.
Hey, let's check out this park. Oh, wow, that's really cool. To find a great local park or forest near you, go to discovertheforest.org.
Patriotism. It inspires passionate debate, and it's worn like a badge of honor with good reason, because it means love and devotion for one's country. But what really makes up this country of ours? It's the people. To love America is to love all Americans. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, sexuality, disability, race, religion, and other labels. Because love has no labels.